Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Hurley. And good afternoon, dear members of the Council of the BDF. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You don't have to answer me, it's fine. I would like, first of all, to introduce the couple that is going to assist me this afternoon in the lecture. They are famous dancers in their own right, former world professional Latin champions, Miss Bianca Schreiber and Hansi Galke from Germany. We have been given a theme to this afternoon, which is titled Quality or Quantity. Not very easy, because it is a vast topic. Quality on its own is a measure of level, of degree, and one very often, more than once, automatically thinks about technique when the word quality is being used. And I do find that, yes, that is not altogether wrong, because in order to have quality, there has to be a certain amount of trained discipline in the person that is going to execute a form of either movement with quality or anything that has the tag quality on it, has to do with a certain level. Quantity is a measure of amount. How much is very easy to say. I'm not English. A lot of you are not English. But we are talking English here today and trying to make everybody understand. So quantity is basically how much of something. Now, quantity, one automatically maybe thinks of, when we're talking about dancing, something big, and very often forgetting how little is also possible to use of quantity. Quantity, I find, relates itself a lot to impulse of what one might decide maybe to do at that moment without having maybe the discipline of quality. But I don't mean that quantity is always without discipline or quality, to the contrary. And in trying to prepare for this lecture, and with the two words that I had been given, I suddenly found, oh, there's an interesting little thing coming up, because quality or quantity, we could also say it is very important how much quantity of the quality that we are going to use, or how much quality is it in the quantity of what we are going to do. So, deep thoughts maybe, food for thought. Having chosen today, those who have looked into the notes, I have chosen to use this topic, quality or quantity, and relate it to how one listens to music. Because a dancer uses their body as language, a means of expression. And the reason for this expression is that they hear a sound which then decides what kind of movement you will then do. But it's very important also that we are talking here today about competitive Latin American dancing or competitive ballroom dancing. And of course, in some way, we are expected to listen to certain types of music in order to do certain types of movement which so-called fit into the structure of ballroom or Latin American competitive dancing. I find it extremely important to make dancers understand that they have to maybe get trained to find out what an ear should pick up, because we have the quality, if I might refer to technical side of the dancing, that needs the rhythmical section of the music in order to express itself. Then we have the fact that in ballroom dancing, from years gone back, we are expected, whether it's Latin or ballroom, that two people moving together has a certain kind of couple design externally in their work. And those movements, more than normal, lends itself to the melody side of music. We have also vocal music, which probably affects a little bit interpretive personality, because it might inspire the character sometimes of the dancer to express something in a certain way at that moment. Anyway, I would like to first let you listen to four pieces of rumba. Roy, number one, can you please put, this is an instrumental, relatively authentic piece of rumba music. Instrumental melody being played predominantly by a piano, but with a very clear percussion rhythmical section in the background. However, for the fact of the instrument being low, we were able to put the instruments of the rhythm and the percussion in the foreground. I then want you to listen to a version number two, also characteristic, also instrumental, also with percussion, but also with a vocal.
Del amor, amor que brilló con fulgor.
both these pieces that you have listened to have been romantic. They have probably been what people would automatically think that rumba is, because they gave you a sort of relaxed, laid-back feeling. However, if one was attentive enough to listen to the percussion side, like we will later demonstrate to you, the slowness is not there, inasmuch there is a lot of staccato activity within the body if one listens and follows the rhythmical section. Example number three is, and you have to take that forward 40 seconds, thank you, is a beautiful piece of music from Jekyll and Hyde.
Rhyme, give me this moment, this precious chance. I'll gather up my past and make some sense at last. This is the moment when all I've done, all of the dreaming and scheming and screaming become one.
Okay, thank you, Roy. Now that had a lot of quantity in it, wouldn't you say? It's almost like the fullness of the volume of this beautiful melodic piece urged you to basically give it all in places. Well, we'll have a look at that afterwards. And then I want to let you hear a piece of contemporary music, which is interesting because it is instrumental and vocal, and it has also used as a base the rhythm section of the original percussion, but used with machines and today's technology. Please. So as you see, four pieces of music, all rumba, all different. And as we have such great dancers as Hansi and Bianca here this afternoon, I am going to ask them to show me and you how they feel different to three of these different pieces of music. So if we will start with number one. Yes, and that is the one that had the instrumental authentic touch to it. Now, what I find so interesting in exactly what they did was that the interpretation of the rhythmical action of the body, when we often talk about being on bones, to put your weight down, was never lost in the midst of the easy, you can almost say floating image of the melody. Now, if we then go to from authentic to, and I know that Hans in particular loves this kind of chance, it's the number 3, the Jekyll and Hyde. Would you forward that 40 seconds, please? This is basically the piece of music with no rhythm.
Rhyme, give me this moment, this precious chance. I'll gather up my past and make some sense.
I'm sure you noticed a slight change in length of step. Potency, use of power, accents, but still, where possible, the maintenance of the non-existing beats of rhythm, because the bodies have been trained that certain actions should have these elements. But we also could see, even though very impressive, the danger in all dancing going to external power play, like very easily done, when this becomes your base for your dancing. Then we have the chains and number 4, please, Roy, which has the contemporary touch to the dunk, but rhythm. The natural vamp in Bianca coming out.
Where I am, but I'm not baby.
Now, I think it was quite obvious to see how the different kinds of music changed the way Hansi and Bianca danced basically the same choreography. And of course, in competitions, we don't have the chance to prepare our dancing to certain pieces of music. Basically, one never knows what piece of music is going to be played at what time. And one has to be a very, very advanced dancer to rely on spur of the moment impulse to change the way you dance. But what I'd like for you to understand by this lecture here today, that in the preparation progress, development of a dancer, the dancer should be made to become aware of the various aspects of body use depending on how you get taught to pick up what sound from the music that is being played for you to use. And this can be a very, very important aspect in the construction of a competitive routine, so that there are almost elements, because surely we do want variety of light and shade, changes of energy, showing quality of dance movement. Do you know one thing that I think is very, very important? I keep on saying dance action. I wish the world would understand that dance action based on basics, basic dance action is basic. You don't have to do the open hip twist, follow into fan and hockey stick step pattern in order to dance basic. It is the way your body works. It is the way your legs walk, using a leg action in the walk. It is the way your hip action gets developed from that walk, related to the use of awareness of upper body, so that you are able to express the rhythm action also above the waistline. Now, could I ask Hansi and Bianca just to do some side by side, some basic rumba? Would you play number 4, please? Chains, please. The 4th one. Yeah. And I want them now to dance just a basic step, starting from the back basic, side by side, and notice the body action. There should be a tick going on in your body. Zak kang 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 kang. Zak kang pam pam ka zak kang pum pum pam pam. Will you just do it just with legs once? 4, 2, 3, 4. It looks like the legs are made of rubber. 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. Now, the awareness of this action, which is so important also then to know about, because in this quality we have also quantity. Because just by doing a cucaracha, for example, now I would like Hansi and Bianca just to do 4 cucarachas with easy leg action and a drift of hip action, And then I'd like you to do another four with accentuated, deliberate, how much amount of body action you would like to come. Okay? Start on your right foot, please. Four of each. This is just using legs only. Now the body action. And if there is quantity, they decide how much visuality is going to come out of. Thank you. How much visuality is going to come out of that simple little movement. Well, I never realized I had planned a lot of things to talk about. Let me just say one thing, because having the chance of Hansi and Bianca with me here this afternoon, to finish off, we have planned a little piece of dancing for you, which we hope will lend itself to have quality and quantity and listening to the music, and let's hope also a little bit of entertainment value in it. However, I just want to say one thing. Remember, a dance couple is two people dancing together. Four sets of ears who hear the music at the same time. However, one is going to lead and one is going to follow. So how to understand about connection, lead and follow, principles of adapting your body to follow these things, to be in tune with one another, is extremely important. A necessity. Ladies and gentlemen, before we finish, of course, I would like to thank not only Hans and Bianca for being such wonderful demonstrators here this afternoon, but also the BDF committee. Thank you for inviting me once again at the Congress here. And to you all, let's say thank you with a little piece of something that we have cooked up. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, doesn't it make you sick? In my opinion, Espen has got to be one of the most brilliant and talented lecturers that it's been my pleasure to listen to. He's so innovative, and when I see him dance out there now, the hair's gone a little bit different colour, the body's changing shape of it, but there's still that fabulous dancer inside. And wouldn't it be wonderful if all couples in the world could have regular lessons with the type of lecturers we've had this morning? Would be wonderful, wouldn't it? To open their eyes to the depths of dancing. Ladies and gentlemen, once more, please welcome back Espen Solberg and Hansi and Bianca.